Yet here in Chicago, that right is being diluted and minimized by a new kind of vote fraud. Thousands of people who are not even American citizens are getting that right to vote through illegal means. Roberta Baskin has details in an exclusive Target 7 investigation.
Roberta?
Tim, Target 7 found non-citizens registered to vote in every ward we looked at. When these people vote, it's a serious crime. But in Chicago, non-citizens do get voters' cards and they do vote, no questions asked. Carlos is a citizen of Mexico, but he had no trouble registering to vote in Chicago.
I go to City Hall and they give it to me easy. They don't ask for identification.
Jose Lariosa is a citizen of the Philippines. He voted for the first time in November after registering at his local library. And you told them that you were not yet a citizen.
Yes, I told them I'm not yet a citizen.
But they said that it was okay.
Yes.
Shokumbi is a citizen of Nigeria, but he is registered to vote in Chicago.
I told him I was born here, and he, you know, he said, well, that was good enough.
Where did you say you were born?
Kentucky.
And did he say anything about that?
No, he didn't.
Target 7's review of thousands of the Board of Elections' own records uncovered the names of many non-citizens, all of them certified to vote. We brought our evidence to federal officials.
The registration process itself seems to be very inadequate when an illegal alien can walk right in with no identification and being basically non-English speaking and register to vote and in fact vote.
I'm quite disturbed when I see the vast number of illegal aliens that appear to be registered to vote in the city of Chicago. You have to be a United States citizen to vote. And what bothers me is the most is that when you have this number of illegal registrations, what you're doing is you're laying the groundwork to have fraud on Election Day.
Fraud the Board of Elections is unaware of.
I have no knowledge of illegal aliens voting in Chicago.
But they do vote. Mario Castaneda, one day after the November election, he was arrested by immigration carrying this proof that he voted in his pocket. He was using his voter's registration card to try and get a U.S. passport. Andras, Garcia, he's voted in at least three elections. Ramon Ramirez, he had proof of his Dominican Republic citizenship right next to his Chicago voter's card. Teresa Alvarez de Lopez, she bought a set of documents in the name of a dead woman, Ofelia Moreno. Then she used the voter's card to vote in the gubernatorial election. Julio is a Mexican citizen, but he cast his ballot right here in Chicago.
I had the illusion that being Latino, if we did vote, maybe we could get better services.
Other illegal aliens say they were encouraged to vote for Latino candidates.
It was explained to him that by voting, they would give him a voter's registration card if he voted for Juan Soliz.
Who was it that registered your husband to vote?
Tomas Santana.
And did he know that your husband was in the country illegally?
Yes.
Tomas Santana first agreed to talk about his campaign activity, but when we got to his office, he had disappeared. He's been unavailable ever since. The candidate for whom he was working was Juan Soliz.
I would be shocked to learn that one of my campaign workers would be involved in that kind of activity, simply because we don't stand for that kind of activity at all.
Other political workers also encourage people to vote, whether they know they're citizens or not. Take Joe Quintana.
Well, you know, I work for the city too, you know, and then it's part of the reason. I work for the city. Hey, you know, we go out there, vote together. Why not? Hey, I want to keep my job, you know? Is there anything wrong with that?
Joe Quintana owns the Heartbreak Hotel, which has 16 tiny rooms. Exactly 17 people are registered to vote here. One of them has two voter registration cards. He's a Mexican citizen named Juan Delgado.
Joe Quintana is the one told us to vote.
Why did you want to?
Because he told us to vote, you know, and we live in his own building, you know. We have to listen to him because he's the owner of the place, you know.
I ask, I go around asking him, who are you voting for? He says, well, for us as well, let's go vote for me and Brad. Why not? Hey, why not?
But why are you encouraging people to vote who aren't citizens?
I'm asking them, who are you voting for? That's all.
And encouraging them to get out and register.
Yeah, sure. Well,
the problem that is created is that if you don't have safeguards built into the system, to prevent illegal registrations, such as people double registering or non-U.S. citizens registering to vote. What you do is that you undermine the entire system because you're, in effect, are setting the foundation to have fraud on Election Day.
Target 7's findings have prompted an unprecedented federal investigation into vote fraud by illegal aliens. And using computers, federal investigators have begun matching up registered Chicago voters with known illegal aliens and immigrants. Thousands of names have already shown up, and that may be a tip of the iceberg.